Hi, this is Dr. Tamara, and today I am with another very nice book's review, which is All in One Homeopathic Materia Medica by Dr. Niranjan Mahanty sir, who amazingly with dedication made this book. And especially this is a true around 1200 pages book, so I have not completed it, but I could grasp that what this book actually contained. So within this few minutes I'm going to give a review that why you should buy and go through this book. So without wasting time, let's get started. So this book is nicely written on the 4 years of Materia Medica syllabus, and especially there are some rare drugs added. Of course our teachers and seniors helps, but in an aggregated form all the notes, especially 4 years of curriculum of homeopathic Materia Medica along with revised and enlarged edition that is containing remedies of new syllabus of CCH is exactly contained here. Year wise revision is given here that this drug in this BHMS, so students can complete according to their syllabus too. And especially I would like to mention that every remedy is having such kind of headings like introductions, then causations, why you will prescribe this medicine, constitutions, there are mental general symptoms given, then physical guiding symptoms, main sphere of action discussed here, that this medicine is applicable in which conditions and in the bodies where the it is applicable. Then relationship discussed in details, thermal relation which has become very controversial for we students, then therapeutic parts, and lastly but not the least the therapeutics along with potencies is described here. So this was totally what the books is having. Introduction to the homeopathic Materia Medica, that is absolutely for your own interest. Then sources of Materia Medica, that is amazingly written and you need it. Types of homeopathic Materia Medica, different ways of studying homeopathic Materia Medica. Yeah, this different ways of Materia Medica really that was a very much important question for me, that where I will get it. In third or fourth BHMS syllabus this was 10 or 15 marks questions. The scope and limitations of homeopathic Materia Medica. You usually homeopaths thinks that we have scope to the power unlimited and there is limitation to the power zero. No, actually where we have scope, where we have limitations. Many other books also having this topic very detailed, but in UG sessions as an undergraduate student here from different collections written so nicely, really I became fan of this article. All right, next their history of homeopathic Materia Medica, that is in the number 10 topic of this first portions, that is really needed. And we usually know that first homeopathic Materia Medica, that is fragment of the Virves, having 27 drugs, but do you know that what drugs are actually it contains? After getting PG in Materia Medica Pura, yes, there the names are mentioned, but here in that line by line, number wise giving that which drugs are there. Then in the Materia Medica Pura, when it came, how Hahnemann launched it, who helped there, who were the provers, this is nicely written. Yeah. Now I am coming to the BHMS curriculum CCH, all the drugs enlisted here in the heading of first BHMS, second BHMS, in third and fourth BHMS, all the drugs are given all in one form, so you will get it very easily. And the most interesting portions that in UG sessions it becomes very hectic for searching various unknown drugs like especially the adrenaline, meningitis, these are usually not x-ray, usually we can find it out from the basic books. Yeah, of course I will always suggest to go through the basics books of always forever, but this book will help you for the examinations for sure. Now I'm describing one drug which is very useful and we commonly use, that is Nux Vomica. This is very difficult in short book review to say each and every drug or more than one drug. So one drug I'm giving you example that how it is arranged and why you should go through this book. Yeah, just like Nux Vomica in the heading form, its common name and family name is mentioned, along with in the introduction sections of what is the meaning and how this drug came, who proved it, and why first it used. So such kind of history you will get here. Then causations. Yeah, elements from is one of the main and most important portions you all know. So my brothers and sisters, while going through this study, you will feel like all the portions are arranged so nicely that it is capturing in your brain and in your long-term memory so easily. Then there are constitutions, portion, and like appearance and temperament, that is not only for your examination purpose, for prescribing also this will help you a lot. Mental generals are described so good. Yeah, just like Nag Bhumika, how you will think of Nag Bhumika for a patient. Mental, physical, all the guiding symptoms are described here. And most important and good portions are filled here, the comparison portions. Just like against one single symptom, not only Nag Bhumika, but what other medicines are coming in also described here. Along with that, here in the portions of single heading of pathological conditions like gastric symptoms, fever of Nag Bhumika, you my juniors know that especially in UG there is portion comes, so like describe respiratory disorders of Nag Bhumika. We think of that from which portions we have to write it down, but here in the point of examination purpose is given nicely. Along with the last sections, I'd like to mention here potencies also given directions. But as far just like one of my great teacher used to say, that potency apna apna, that is on your own experience. Last, I'd like to say that of course you should buy this book, especially UGPG students and all the homeopaths who are very much interested to know about the UG and PG curriculums of Mater Medica and medicines. So this will help them very well. And finally, I wish you all a very happy, healthy Durga Puja. Enjoy your time, but of course not without study. Keep smiling, stay healthy. Thanks for watching.